Information available to the patrolling troops indicated the presence of suspects, suspected cultists in Okariki village. The troops moved in and raided the suspected criminal hideout. One person lost his life at the hideout while several others fled. Later it was confirmed that the person who lost his life was a Nigerian footballer identified as Mr. Izu Joseph.
The commander, 2 Brigade Nigerian Army, Brigadier General Amisu Azan, explaining the circumstances that led to the death of a Nigerian footballer, Joseph Izu. Following the tension generated by the incident, we took a trip to Okaki community, which sits on the boundary between Rivers and Bayelsa states by the bank of Orashi River. The occupation of the people here is mainly farming and fishing. There is an easy calm in the air as we walk through the pathway to the alleged cultist shrine where the Nigerian footballer was reportedly shot. This area is popularly called Ghetto in Okaki community in Oda West local government area of Rivers State. And according to the army, this is a cultist shrine linked to the unfortunate death of the Nigerian footballer Joseph Izu.
I ran inside the...
This eyewitness narrates stories that seem to differ from the earlier one by the army.
I was peeping towards the window and I saw this particular guy. They shot that the pillar, they shot him through his leg. He was screaming and he was trying to crawl. They were asking him, what did you went there to do in that shrine? What did you went there to do in that shrine? And he said, I didn't went any place. So I'm innocent though. I'm a footballer. He brought his ID card and showed them. They now checked his ID card and it was confirmed that he's a footballer. And that was how they shot him.
Meanwhile, this suspected cultist claims he was present with the late footballer at the ghetto when the army stormed the area.
When I went there, Izu itself was inside the ghetto. One of the guys stood up and said that they are coming. So we now all fell into the water and Izu ran away too. And when I saw that it was Nigerian army, so I now surrender.
Our findings take us to his home in the community, found to be under lock and key with no one around. The next port of call is the home of the paramount ruler of the community. The visibly angry ruler speaks on the matter.
I, as a person, have proclaimed, move around this community. I have destroyed that place. So it's unfortunate. Whoever might have fallen victim, let him take it with good faith.
According to the army, a formal report will be presented at the end of investigations. However, family and friends are hopeful that justice will prevail. Emmanuel Irey, Channels Television News.